Bless you and welcome, welcome, welcome to 30 Days of Prayer with Bishop Lipman. I'm so excited to welcome you here and to have you to share in this mini series on the book of Philippians. I want to encourage you to visit my website at www.bishoplipman.org. You will find there additional content for your continual development spiritually. There are a number of blog posts. There is a link to my podcast, which is the Integrity Podcast, and you will find information on YouTube channels and all of those kinds of wonderful things. And so I invite you to like, share, and subscribe, and do visit often. On yesterday, we began in the book of Philippians with a time of meditation and study, and we looked in particular at verse number 6 of chapter number 1. Which says, being confident of this very thing, that he who has begun a good work in you will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. And we're calling this little mini-series Peace in the Midst of It All. We all need peace right now in the midst of all that we are dealing with, whether that is job loss or whether that is illness, whether that is concern over loved ones in a various states that have become hot spots. We all need the peace of God right now. And Paul, while in jail and in prison, wrote this letter of joy that is replete with joy and power and victory and favor and peace. And he gives this letter of encouragement in 4 little short chapters to the church at Philippi, whom he loved and who loved him very, very dearly. So on yesterday, we talked about how you can have calm in chaos and how you can have comfort in chaos. Today, I want to move just a little bit down the page of your scriptures, and I want to go to the 12th through the 18th verses, and I'm going to quickly highlight what it says and then lead you in a time of prayer. But today's meditation is, God can use these chains. God can use these chains. Remember, Paul is shackled and he is imprisoned for preaching the gospel. He is unaware of what his outcome will be, what his life looks like in the next few days or even weeks, quite like where we are right now. Not quite sure of what the outcome will be or what the forecast is or what the climate looks like. However, we can have that same peace and joy that the Apostle Paul has, that he gives to the church at Philippi, that we now give to you via this powerful little 4-chapter book called Philippians. So let's go to today's verses. First of all, I want to look at Philippians chapter 1, verse number 12 from the Living Bible translation. And there you will find these words. If you're on the phone with us, it's Philippians chapter 1, verse number 12. And Paul says in the Living Bible translation, "And I want you to know this, dear brothers, everything that has happened to me here has been a great boost in getting out the good news concerning Christ." Paul is in jail, and yet he's writing this letter of hope, of encouragement, and of joy, and of peace to the people of God at Philippi, who had questions but no answers. And Paul says, "Thank you for your concern for my confinement. Thank you for praying for me while I'm in my chains. But number one, I want you to know that God can use these chains. God can use this time of confinement. God can use this time of sequester and shut in and this time of social distancing. Number one, because chains birth challenges. Chains give birth to challenges. Now, what do I mean by that? I simply mean that Paul was confined and he was going through a period of literally being handcuffed to a Roman soldier 3 times a day for an 8-hour shift, making 24 hours. And every time he was chained to a Roman soldier, he thought about the fact that ultimately he wanted to go and preach at the amphitheater in Rome. Yet he took advantage of the challenge that he was facing in order to advance the cause of his calling and the cause of Christ. And here's what I want to say to you, as Paul says to us through this passage for our 21st century right now situation, that though we may feel as though we are in chains, that we are in shackled, that we are limited, that we are restricted, Actually, God can use these chains because chains give birth to challenges. Now, what do I mean by challenges? Simply this. God wants you to find innovation in your situation. You see, this is not a time to give up, to quit, to throw in the towel. It's not a time to surrender and to succumb. This is the time to allow your chains to challenge you to find ways to make things work. That's exactly what Paul did. Paul didn't hang up his ministerial license and say, forget it. Paul did not return his paperwork back to Gamaliel and back to the elders and the council that promoted him in ministry. No, instead, he found ways to do what he had to do. And in a very practical manner, let me speak to you now, that let these chains bring challenges into your life. And that is, see it as a challenge to continue your finances. See it as a challenge to make things happen. You see, many of us are waiting on a stimulus check. I want to tell you, rather than waiting on something to happen, now is the time to make something happen. Several years ago, Bishop T.D. Jakes said, almost 20 years ago, I think it was, that the Garden of Eden had four rivers in it, and those rivers flowed into the Garden of Eden. And he took that and made that the analogy that all of us need four streams of income, four streams of revenue. And if it never made sense before, now it does. Because if one stream shuts down and another shuts down and a third shuts down, you still have something trickling into your world. And so this is a time that we have to look at the chains as a challenge to be innovative. Pick up the phone, call your mortgage company, make arrangements, call your car finance company, make arrangements. Don't allow anything to cause you to fear and to stop living, but instead take the challenge and let this time of being chained create innovation within you. And that's exactly what the Apostle Paul did. And he says in that 12th verse, I want you to know this, dear brothers, everything that has happened to me here has been a great boost in getting out the good news concerning Christ. So let everything that happens here in this spot of confinement, of shutdown, of shelter in place, actually be looked at as a challenge that enables you to promote what you were already doing and find new ways to do it even greater. Now, we look at the 13th verse, and there Paul says, for everyone around here, including all the soldiers over at the barracks, knows that I am in chains, watch this, simply because I am a Christian. Now, this is really important, and it's already on the screen, that how you handle the chains is advertisement for Christ. Don't miss that. How you deal with this time of being chained is actually advertisement, positive or negative, for Christ. You see, how you handle this difficult time is a reflection on the God that you serve. And so if you handle it inappropriately, what if Paul had yelled and fussed and cussed and hollered and screamed at the soldiers and cursed everybody out because he didn't feel like they were being fair to him? What if he was fussing at Caesar or yelling toward their governmental authorities? What if he was rebelling toward the government like a lot of churches are doing right now? And what if he was doing all of that? His advertisement for Christ would have been negative press. And listen, who would have wanted to listen to him preach about a Christ of love, a Christ of honor, if he is showing the exact opposite of love and honor? The answer is simple. No one would have heard him. His message would have been in vain, and he would have lost out on the opportunity to minister through his misery. So how you handle the chains is an advertisement for Christ. Let your attitude be one that everyone who comes around you and into contact with you will know that Jesus lives big in you. But then we go to the next verse, and there Paul says to us in verse number 14, "And because of my imprisonment, many of the Christians here seem to have lost their fear of chains. Somehow, my patience has encouraged them, and they have become more and more bold in telling others about Christ." What a powerful verse, verse 14 is. And here's the second point that we learn from this mini series today, is that chains build confidence. Again, chains build confidence. Paul says, because of how I have handled this, and because of my imprisonment, many of the Christians have lost their fear of the situation that I'm in. Isn't that powerful? That our conduct and our behavior can shift the attitude of others who are going through the same situation, and those who fear going through the same situation. Pardon me. Now, Paul says it's because of this that they no longer fear the chains. Somehow, my patience has encouraged them, and they have become more and more bold in telling others about Christ. So how you handle your chains, your time of difficulty, can influence the confidence of other people. Are people watching you and seeing Jesus at work in you? Are they watching you and seeing what God can do, even in chains? Look at verse 18. Pardon me. Verse 18. "But whatever their motive for doing it, the fact remains that the good news about Christ is still being preached, and I am glad." Number three, we learn that chains bring change. Chains bring change. Your life can be better if you handle these chains, this time of shutdown and social distancing, with the proper mentality. And how you handle it can motivate others to do something different. Maybe somebody is waiting on you to open up your business now as a motivation for them to open up their business. He says, whatever the motives are, that there were people who were preaching, some against him, some were trying to take away his following in Philippi, some were just pop-up preachers that overnight decided to make themselves a minister. But Paul says, whatever the motive is, I don't even have time to worry about their motive. The fact remains that the good news about Christ is being preached, and I am so glad. So the change that we're going through can bring changes in other people. And this is not a time for us to be overly concerned with what other people are doing, with what other people have, with what other people are doing with their time. This is a time for us to concentrate on what we were created to do, to concentrate on our calling, to concentrate on what God put us on earth to do. Stop worrying about the Joneses, the Williamsons, the Jacksons, the Henrys, the Watts, all of them, and focus on your purpose for being on this earth. So chains can bring change. Now, I want you to see this next set of verses here. And because Paul tells us that even though they are preaching with the wrong motives, even though they have a mindset that is designed for some to be building their little churches now while Paul is in jail, Paul is like, man, whatever. Verse 18, all I need to see is change coming out of my chains. So I want you to stop worrying about what everybody else is concentrating on or doing or their deeds. And listen, this is really a time for us to clean out our minds and clean out our hearts and to start saying, Lord, you're my focus. You are my intention. I don't have time to concentrate on what everybody else is doing. As long as you're getting the glory, that's all that matters in my life. That's what the Lord wants to bring in our lives and in our hearts, is that we focus on what he has designed and destined and created us to do. And that is to be who the Lord has called us to be. So I want to pray with you now. Let's send up some hearts. Let's raise our hands, even at home, and let's just pray unto our great God, who is our great King. And let's intercede one for another, that God would indeed use our chains. I think God wants to bless us in spite of our chains, in spite of what we're dealing with, in spite of where we are. Do you believe that? I absolutely believe that. So I want to pray with you now. Let's go before the throne of grace and ask the Lord to use our chains that we can have peace in the midst of it all. Let's pray. Our great God, our great Father, our great peacemaker, thank you for these words from the Apostle Paul that motivate us to concentrate not on our situation, not on our circumstances, not on our pain, but on our peace. And Father, we take your word seriously today. We thank you that you care enough about us to speak to us even in the midst of pandemic. Thank you that your word is still good and it's still great and it's still awesome and it's still powerful and it's still amazing. Thank you, Lord, for speaking to us through the Apostle Paul that we may know that our chains are designed to bring us greatness. Our chains, our situations that we may seem to feel are endless, and even though we don't know when it's going to be over, God, we thank you for what we're learning from the Apostle Paul that teaches us to live until the day we die, and that even though we may be in a situation where we feel chained, you can still use it. So God, use this time of chains. Lord, use this time of strain. Use this time of difficulty. Use this time, oh God, where we feel imprisoned, where we feel locked down, and to remind us that no weapon that is formed against us can ever prosper. Father, thank you for this time that you have slowed us down. God, I remind your people now of your word in Psalm 23 that says, he maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. Father, we recognize that no matter what intentions the enemy may have had in this time of shutdown, in this time of shelter at home, in this time of pandemic disease, your purpose is far greater, because you have given us a chance to breathe again, to rest again. You have put us in a position to trust you like never before. And so, God, we thank you. We thank you. We love you. We appreciate you, because you love us enough to provide for your children. Now, God, as I stretch my hands toward this camera, I pray for my brothers and sisters right now, Lord, that you would meet every need. God, that you would raise up ideas for revenue. Father, that you would give us a peace of mind that produces streams of revenue. God, birth something out of these chains. Birth new ideas. Birth new businesses. Father, turn old habits and practices practices and old hobbies into new entrepreneurship. Cause us to be innovative like the Apostle Paul was. And God, don't let us just sit back and watch things happen. But God, give us the motivation right now to pick up the phone, to get on the internet, to do some research, to make some phone calls, to make some things happen. And Father, we know you've already made the way clear. You've already opened the door. You've already provided, because you're that kind of father. You take good care of your children, even when your children are not good children. So Lord, we praise you right now. We thank you. We love you. We honor you for our chains. Thank you for using our chains to bring change in us, in those that we influence, and in all of those who are watching us that might even be adversity. Thank you that we're going to be a good advertisement. Thank you that we're going to be good role models. Thank you that we're going to be good show-stopping models of what your mercy can produce in a heart that is changed in spite of the chains. And God, we ask that you would bless our president, that you would bless all first responders, all doctors, all nurses. God, even those who clean the hospitals, bless them, encourage their hearts, lift their spirit. And God, give them prosperity and favor, health and wealth. Keep them well, God. And for whatever you do, we'll give you all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. And amen. Thank you for joining me today for our 30 Days of Prayer and for this mini-series on the book of Philippians. I want to remind you very quickly to tune in tomorrow at 7:30 p.m. for Bible study. You can find it on YouTube at Dr. A. Reginald Littman or New Mountaintop Baptist Church. It will be posted to both, and we're in part 5 at this point, 3 tips for interpreting Scripture. So I look forward to sharing with you in Bible study. I look forward to sharing with you every day, Monday through Friday, until further notice, for 30 Days of Prayer. Be sure to join us on tomorrow, Monday through Friday, 12 noon. The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord lift up his favor upon you. The Lord bless you in your going out and in your coming in. The Lord keep you from this time, now, henceforth, and forever. Do me a favor. Make sure you share this video with a friend. I love you. Have an amazing and powerful day. God bless you.